Good morning, everyone. Learning the Maim of Vaydaber Hashem El Moshe, which is a Maim on Pashas Chukas. And we ended off yesterday by the Bamachus Oisid Beis, by 12, page Chaf Aleph, 21. The last part that we discussed was although Moshe Rabbeinu was spiritually and physically wealthy in all aspects, he was wealthy, and therefore his prayer is not for himself. His prayer was for other people because he was not deficient of anything. But since he was connected with the Jewish people, and the Jewish people were deficient, they were deficient in the Giluim, in the revelations that he was exposed to, he was not exposed to. Meaning, revelations that he was exposed to, they were not exposed to. So, since Moshe Rabbeinu's primary thing was not that he was connected with Atzilus, was not that he... All the qualities he had was not his main thing. One thing was his primary thing, that he was the shepherd of Am Yisrael. And since they were lacking, Jewish people were lacking the revelation that he was exposed to, in a way, it was also affecting him. So therefore, when he... Davin, they should be exposed and received from the same place that he is receiving, or that they should, Am Yisrael, the Jewish people should have the same revelation that he has, and when they had it, he himself was benefiting from it. In line one, this is associated with the extension of Moshe Rabbeinu, the offshoots of Moshe Rabbeinu in every generation. All the way down to the previous Rebbe, Baal HaGeula, his liberation was on the 12th and the 13th of Tammuz. What was his main theme? That it was the shepherd of Am Yisrael. And the challenges, the issues of Am Yisrael was his issues. Appreciation of what, meaning he saw it as his issues. What was the novelty of the liberation? The Yutis Kislev Gula Deus Tammuz. 19th of Kislev was the liberation of the Alter Rebbe. And the 12th of Tammuz was the liberation of the previous Rebbe, of Yosef Yitzchak. The Yudvis Tammuz, the Master Shukri, Toron Eir Menachishach. It says it's like the advantage of light that comes from darkness. On their level, on a personal level, to them it's not being in darkness. Why? The famous talk that the previous Rebbe gave in regards to his imprisonment. In regards to the imprisonment of the Alter Rebbe, that he himself agreed to the imprisonment. Meaning that if he didn't want it to happen, he could easily stop it. So the concealment of the imprisonment is only an external. But innerly, even at the time of the imprisonment, they are above any kinds of limitation. And the proof is that they agreed to it. And if they did not agree to it, the imprisonment would not take place. with all the miracles that we saw with the Alter Rebbe. Ech naisar dezitona. So seemingly, how can the imprisonment lead to the advantage of light that comes through darkness? Going back to the theme that we said before, that the main quality of a Nasi, of a leader, is that he is a leader of Am Yisrael, not his personal qualities, and not his connection with Hashem, his righteousness, his greatness. That's not his main thing. His main thing that he's a leader of Am Yisrael. Shavuot Yisrael, the shepherd of Am Yisrael, and the Nasi Yisrael, Lochin, Elam, Vestal, Dam, Yisrael, Shabbat, Gadi, Ve'yun, Gai, Yisrael. Therefore, the concealment of the imprisonment. Who suffered from the concealment? It was the Hasidim, the Jewish people. They didn't see the Rebbe. It was taken away from them. Well, investor, gamle gab, and if there is a concealment within, if there is concealment, Am Yisrael creates also an impact the Nasi as well, the leader as well. Velochem begulam amaisan. Therefore, at the time of redemption, shachoshech nepachlo, when darkness turned into light, Nasi tovanoy. Now there's the advantage of light over darkness. Yud Gimel. Vein is bol esh hashachus daigulu diskisu dibistamu zamiot fiyol meishe. We discussed a lot in this maimer, the chapter 90 in the book of Psalms, where it says over the Tefillah L'Moshe, and we said before that this is a wealthy man's prayer. So what's the connection between the 19th of Kislev, which was the liberation of the Alter Rebbe, 12th of Tammuz, the liberation of the Friedrich Rebbe, and the Mizmor Tefillah L'Moshe? So specific things that are mentioned in this capital, in this chapter, and also its substance, its teichen, and generally the what the capital is speaking about. It says Tefillah L'Moshe, we said it's Tefillah Oshu, it's a wealthy man's prayer. We know that it's a mizmor that is associated with the 19th of the month. So that's already shaychus, that's already a connection to the Chag HaGeulah, to the day of liberation. What is Ashius? What does it mean? Tfilas Oshir, Moshe's wealthy man. What does it mean, Moshe's wealthy man? It says, Ashius, wealthy means Ugilui Atzim Sinsef. If you are exposed to the revelation of the essence of Ein Sof, Shelemailu Misevev, your Oshu. That's what Oshu means. Not that you have X amount of money. But here, speaking about Ashius, obviously Moshe Rabbeinu was a wealthy man also on the financial level, but a true Ashius over here tells us Gilui Atzmus, since the revelation of the essence of the infinite light. You are exposed to it, it is revealed to you. And what is Atzmus Ein Sof, the essence of the infinite light, is a level that is above the encompassing light. What's special about the prayer of the wealthy man? Prayer of a wealthy man is someone that does not pray for himself. Okay, he prays for other people. Because he is lacking nothing. He's lacking nothing. So therefore, he prays for other people. But in a plain is Gzorshiti Bone. Like the example of the Midrash mentioned about three types of people that come to ask for the king for something. One guy is asking for himself. The prayer that the king gets excited about is someone that asks for other people. Within a plane is gzoshti bon, like so and so country make a decree, is asking the king to make a decree that it will be built. So what is Moshe Rabbeinu praying for? He wants, as we said before, he wants to ask what the levels that he's exposed to. We said he's Asher, he's a wealthy man, so he's exposed to the essence of Ein Sof. So we want the essence of Ein Sof to be drawn down all the way to Malchus. That's what Moshe Rabbeinu wants. And that's what he's asking. Binyan HaMalchus. Bichdei Shebinyan HaMalchus Amdino. He doesn't just want it to happen one-time thing. He wants this revelation from the essence of Ein Sof to come to Malchus, to come to the level of sovereignty, the lowest level. But it should happen ad-yad. It should be an everlasting flow, everlasting revelation. How is it going to happen, an everlasting revelation? Through the essence of Ein Sof. So what happened in 19th of Kislev, the 19th of and the 12th of Tammuz? Revelation of Atzmus Ein Sof. Revelation of the essence of Ein Sof that is above Memale, above the intrinsic light and above the encompassing light, Seviv. The 19th of Kislev and 12th of Tammuz, it was a revealed miracle. Back then, if you were taken, somebody was taken to jail, especially on the accusations that the Rabbein were accused for, the chance of even lasting in jail was, even continuing being in jail and not dying right away, not being killed right away, was very slim. Let alone be exonerated and let alone being freed. It was a revealed miracle that is above nature. Nevertheless, the miracle was above nature but enclosed in nature. It was a combination of miracle and nature together. Although the miracle was enclosed in nature, it was in such a way that the nature did not conceal the miracle. Even the nations of the world saw the Shizon Nes Golu, they saw it, revealed the miracle. The nature of Teva, the nature of the root of nature is from the name Elohim, from the name of God, Elohim, Memale, which is the intrinsic light, Memale. It's the name, Elohim is the name that is associated with Malakolamin, with the godly light that is filling the world, that is enclosed within the limitations of created being and the nature of the world, and where are the roots of miracle coming from? Is Mishem Havaya, Seviv Kolam. So miracles are coming from Seviv, from Shem Havaya, which is above creation. Since when it comes to Yutes Kislev and Yud Beis Tammuz, it was a revelation of the essence of Ein Sof at the time of the Geula. Shemala miseivu mala, akolu mechaber shnem, that is above seivim, above mala, that puts both of them together. Lo chenais the Geula beifin shanes v'atem eschabu yachad. So therefore, the Geula was in such a way that the Nes, the miracle, and the nature came together. Yichud avaya v'lekim. Combination of Shem Havaya, combination of Shem Elohim. So, since this miracle put both, two things came together. On one side it was a miracle, on one side it was enclosed in nature, but the nature did not conceal the miracle. So it says that there's a combination of the unity of Avaya Elokim. Avaya is the miracle, Elokim is the concealment, both of them came together. So the redemption was on one hand in a miracle that is above nature, on the other hand enclosed in nature, in such a way that the enclosement in nature does not conceal that we are dealing with a miracle. Shleimar, Shagil, Deon Sev Shemar Misevev, revelation of Ein Sof that is above Sevev Kolami, Shemar Misevev Mal, revelation of Ein Sof, the infinite light that is above, encompassing and intrinsic light, Bechibur the Nes, which you have within it also miracle, a miracle that is rooted from Sevev, v'teva sheshor shemal, urak shenirgash bohem, inyan shemal mishnem. It says, what is noticeable within both, within Sevev and within Mimala, that there is something happening, something that is above both of them. Shaledei zem ischabr, and because it is something that is higher than both, they come together. This we see even with people, sometimes two people that have a strife or dispute, God forbid, and have they go to someone that they both appreciate, he's capable, since he's higher than both of them, that's why they both appreciate that person, he's capable of putting them together, uniting them. So over here, since we're dealing with a revelation of Ein Sof, it is above Sevev, above Memale, it creates a unity between the two. Shaldei zehem ischabum, aval zeh shatev atzmi, hoya oz b'im shalem yisrael nez. Now, the fact that the nature, at that time, 19th of Kislev, Yud Beis Tammuz, the nature did not conceal the miracle, v'ashigam en nagdim, even those who were the opposers, shenishau az v'sok, at the time of the redemption, they remained steadfast with their opposition. U'mekol mok, but nevertheless, they were forced to help. Huchichu l'saya. It's like Haman. He hates Mordechai, but now he is commanded by the king to dress Mordechai, put him on a horse, and walk him around the town. In this scenario, you have menagdim, you have opposers, opposition, and the opposition itself is now forced to help in the redemption. Shaz b'tokpo, huchechu l'saya, they were forced to help. V'aledat tekef shalom b'shichu v'gulo, how it happened that even the opposers are now helping out in the redemption, they are supporting the liberation. Why? Because there was such revelation that is above Memala and above Sevev together in Malchus. So what was revealed in Malchus? Shosho Amiti, the true essence of Malchus was revealed. Now we can understand even more the connection between chapter 90 in Tilim to the redemption, to the prayer of Moshe Rabbeinu, the prayer of a wealthy man, Tfilas Oshir. The Inyan Tfilas Oshir, who said before that the prayer of a wealthy man, that he's not asking for himself. He's asking for a different country. He's asking for other people. Medina Ploinik, Zashtibon, so-and-so country, make a decree that it should be built. So the inner meaning of this request is that you're asking Hashem, the king, Hamshachas Gilui Atzmus Nisov Malchus, asking for the revelation of Ein Sof in Malchus. Through Sfiras HaMalchus, through the attribute of Malchus, which is the last channel that actually gives us, comes from Malchus, level of 70. So if you're revealing Ein Sof within Malchus, it will create an everlasting situation, an everlasting building. Loisif Shaldei Zahibu the Nes V'teva, Shabagula, through the bond of a miracle and nature that took place in the time of the redemption, 19th of Kislev and 12th of Tammuz, Nitan HaKoyach, the power was given, L'chol HaYichim Bochesu, to all those who follow his ways, Shabbala Geula, the one that the miracle took place for him, the Rebbe, the previous Rebbe and the Alter Rebbe, that they will experience such a connection. Koyach lekol ha'olchim b'ochos, all those who follow his ways, she'amuna shelamayla maseichel, belief, emuna, that is above intellect, miracle, tum shachkam maseichel, will be drawn into intellect as well, into nature. She'aseichel lo'yalim v'yaseh emuna, and that the intellect, nature, intellect, should not conceal and hide the faith. V'alderzu b'negal in the futsa m'sof chutsa. It's also connected with the mission and statement of Hasidus, to spread the wellspring of the Baal Shem Tov, the founder of the Hasidus. Shu'utchal b'geula d'yutis Kislev, started in the 19th of Kislev. A lot of opposition. The Alter Rebbe was prosecuted. Because of publishing and publicizing Hasidus, and he was freed. When the moment that he was liberated, now permission was given to even increase. And Yud Bistam was the same thing. 12th of Tammuz, now new possibilities were created, new opportunities are now created to spread Hasidus even more. Sharadei Achibul and Svetav Shabagula, through the bond, through the connection of nature and miracle that took place in the time of redemption. Itan HaKeach La'afitza Mayonus, the Pnimus HaTero. Now we were given the power to spread out, to publicize the Pnimus HaTero, the inner secrets of Torah. But it's going to be in such a way that even though it's chutzah, meaning you're spreading it out, you're giving it to everyone, Nira Begila is still noticeable, it's still revealed that this wellsprings are pnimius haTorah, the inner secrets of Torah. באופן שורם בגול שמיון עשו לא רק פני שהמיונס הם בגילוי, אלא גם מפני שהחוץ נס באופן שנמלם. And why is it still look noticeable and it's still, you can still see that we're dealing with פנימיוס הטרו, with the wellsprings of Hasidus, because it, even the outside is the חוץ of the outside, in the lowest of places that you publicizing it, is not concealing and it's not hiding the wellsprings. Moreover, this becomes a vessel for the wellsprings. And this is a preparation for the fulfillment of the prophecy of Nigla Kvoidavai, the prophecy of Ishaya. I'll see honor of Hashem. And I'll see that Hashem is the one who dibur, who spoke, which means that the flesh will see godliness. Not only because of the gilui, because of the revelation of Kvodavai, tzad haboso atzmo, from the flesh itself will be exposed to likus. You doubt it. Zeu, Vaydaber Hashem El Moshe Davon Yisrael Vikhu Elecha Fora Adumo. Zeh, Shaponik Esh Moshe Meshe. Why Vikhu Elecha Fora Adumo? Why the red heifer is called after Moshe Rabbeinu? Agam Shinyan Mevuchot Shemitzvos Fora Adumo. We said Moshe Rabbeinu only was involved, indirectly involved with the cow. He was not the one to prepare, to make it. He didn't have to prepare it. He is the one that just commanded it. But it still says that all the cows are called, all the red heifers are called after Moshe Rabbeinu. Agam Shinyan Mevuchot Shemitzvos Fora Adumo. What's so unique about the red heifer? Shachuka Shabo Vigili. And the fact that it's a chuk, it's revealed. No one understands it. Besides Moshe Rabbeinu, Chuan Shem Moshe Datam Poro, Moshe himself knew the reason for Poradum. He knew the secret behind it. Ein chiluk mitzvah Poradum. To him, Moshe Rabbeinu himself, there was no difference between mitzvah Poradum and all the other mitzvahs, because he understood all of them. Kaldeish, mitzvah Poradum, Yichuko, Gabi Israel, Chukka Gabi Moshe. Since it was a Chukka, a Choik, to Am Yisrael, to the Jewish people, so Moshe Rabbeinu is the Nasi, it made it Choik for him also. It's Chuk for you, so it's Chuk for me. But he himself, if it was just him alone, it's not a Choik for him because he understands. That's the meaning of speak to the Jewish people, Vikhu Lecho, they should take to you. Through speak to the Jewish people. Al day zeh, meaning the Moshe Rabbeinu was commanded to speak to Am Yisrael. Dabar b'nei Yisrael, speak to us, command us. Al day zeh, what happens? Veikhu alecho. That now it becomes yours. Veikhu alecho, they bring it to you. Ainyan dezeh zchuk asatiro b'negi ala Moshe. Moshe Rabbeinu becomes a chayk. Ela, it becomes a law, something that is above understanding. Ela, shinyan zeh shem Yisrael nimshach l'Moshe b'negi ala mitzvah atzma. This is only in regards to the mitzvah itself. Primarily, the fact that it's a chayk, it's a law, rule, without reason, that's primarily to the Jewish people. Of b'negi ala kiyum mitzvah, when it comes to the fulfillment of the mitzvah, in order for us, for the Jewish people, to do the mitzvah of the red heifer, while there's a kol mitzvahs, bebitul the kabbalah seil, in a way of nullifying themselves, accepting the yoke, both in the chukah chukatik zeh uzalti, Hashem made a choik, made a rule, made a decree, and it's in a skrach al zeh umimoyish, the power to do it properly, with the right attitude, with the right approach. It was given to us through Moshe. The right mindset, the mitzvah was given to us through Moshe. Shinyan u'bitul. Because Moshe Rabbeinu was, his main thing was nullification. V'nachnu ma. Shlem adel shem Moshe l'tam poro. Moshe Rabbeinu knew the reasoning behind poradum. V'abitul the Kabbalah said, Nimshach gam ba'asoga shelo. The nullification, the fact that he was nullified, that he accepted the yoke, was also something that he understood. Nitan akach lechol echad mi'Yisrael, shamuna v'kabol asol, yunach gam b'sechel shelo. It should be also something that you understand, something that you, that's something that sits with you. What is it? The faith. Kabbalah's accepting the yoke. Shleimar the Zohar Shomro Abisin Uzachu Gorgaktik Zohar Zatim Echush Larach Reo. It says that it's a choik, it's a decree, and you don't have permission to ponder over it. What does it mean? Shah Kabbalah Sel Shelo Ibevin Shelo Irak Shemukam Befat Tzivak Hashem Baruch Hu. What does it mean? The acceptance of the yoke is not that you're just doing what Hashem wants from you. It's not just you're just doing it. That's Kabbalah. Meaning there's no doubts when he does something. Because even in his mind, he understands the quality, understand the greatness of Kabbalah said. We can connect the above with the statement of the Midrash. It says that a red heifer is associated with the four exiles, or tells us about the four exiles. So Poro is referring to the exile of being in Mitzrayim. Red is connected with the exile of Babylonia. Temima, that you need to be complete, is associated with Madai, the exile of Madai. And Asherin Bamum, that has no blemish, is the exile of Yavon, of Greek. What is the intellect for him? His intellect is such a way that he understands that he needs to have Kabbalah Seil. He needs to accept the yoke that is above intellect. His intellect understands that there is something that is above intellect. And that's how he serves Hashem, accepting the yoke of heaven. But he understands the greatness of Kabbalah Seil. And that's a preparation for redemption. The godly revelation will be also from the world itself, that the world would stop concealing a godliness, meaning the world itself would reveal godliness, just like we said before, that the flesh itself, the bustle, the flesh itself will be a vehicle to reveal godliness. This is the connection between, this is the rule of the Torah to the burning of the red heifer. But what does Kabbalah say? Accepting the yoke, it's in such a way that he's not pondering over it. He has no doubts. Because even in his mind, he understands the concept of accepting the yoke. It's sitting with him. It's resting with him. He's comfortable with it. Nasa, Sreifa, Sapo. We serve Hashem with accepting the yoke. We're burning the cow. What is it? Burning the red heifer. We're getting rid of exile. Kapiskim Adu the Valagula. Famous statement of the previous Rebbe, the Rabbi Ayat, Rabbi Yosef Yitzchak, a.k.a. Friedrich Rebbe, that Hashem will burn the walls of exile. And we're all marching together with our leaders, with the Baal HaGeulah, with the one who experienced the liberation, Bereishenu, as our leader, LeGeulah Amitis HaShlemu, to the true and complete redemption with the coming of Mashiach, Koramamish, speedily in our days. Vyashim Mashiach, Tkeinu, Koramamish, Bukhim Tiyo.